Hey guys, welcome back for another vlog from Balto. So for today, we will be comparing two dog products, the famous Kong and Dogzilla's treat pod. So we will be talking about Dogzilla first, since this is the first thing that we got. We searched everywhere to get ourselves Kong in large size, but it's out of stock everywhere here in Manila. So I was able to find this Dogzilla treat pod, which works basically the same as your Kong, and we got this from Hobbs and Lands, and it's a little bit more expensive than your Kong, but I feel that Balto loves this more in a way that he is more engaged when using this treat toy or interactive toy. I feel that he appreciates the ridges of the treat pod. He gets to play with this more versus the Kong. He tends to leave the Kong so much faster than the treat pod. Here you can see that he is enjoying the treats that I put. I also noticed that he's not really explorative. He doesn't really like peanut butter. He doesn't really like yogurt. So basically, we've used the treat pod for a lot of dry kibbles, whether treats or kibbles, everything dry, and this sort of dental chewing treat that he loves very much. The treat pod also looks more sturdy, more robust than the Kong. We use classic Kong, so it's a red one. I'm not sure how this would compare to the extreme Kong, the black one, but I feel that treat pods, Dogzilla's treat pods, is more thick and perhaps would last longer. And since I let Balto use this more than the Kong, of course, our treat pod has more wear and tear versus the Kong. Here you can see that he is just enjoying his treat pod even without treats. He lasts for hours with this, even without treats. Okay, so moving on, let's talk about the Kong. Kong is such a famous little product. Almost every dog lover I know has this. I mean, long before I've become a dog mom, I know a lot of dog people use this. Whether small dogs, large dogs, giant dogs, they all have Kongs. So as soon as I got Balto, I was looking for a Kong to give him. And it took me, weeks to get one because, as I've said, it's out of stock everywhere. Even online, even in store. So as soon as I got it, I got one. And after that, again, it's out of stock. Alright, so here you can see that he is playing with his Kong with some of the kibbles. I decided to get more creative with it. I searched for Kong recipes online and tried it. But I discovered that Balto is not really into peanut butter. Perhaps the peanut butter I got is not really delectable because it's peanut butter light. It doesn't contain sugar. It has stevia. So I'm not so sure how that would taste like for a dog, but according to my research, they're not supposed to consume peanut butter with sugar. So I chose this one and it's a fail. So he doesn't really like peanut butter. You know, I decided to give it a try by giving him kibbles and the Kong without the peanut butter. And you can see that he's just not that engaged. He's just not that interested with the Kong versus the treat pod. He tends to leave it just like that. And you know, I just have to clean up after him afterwards as usual. Every time he's using this Kong, he creates this mess. I don't know why. It's just messy and then he'll leave it. Versus when he's using the treat pod, he tends to finish the kibbles, the dry kibbles, then just leave it like that and, you know, leave it for his mom to clean up after him. So if you've ever tried the Kong and the treat pod, do let us know how it went with your fur baby, because definitely Balto's vote is for the treat pod. So yeah, Balto's not that into the Kong. He likes this one so much better. Dogzilla treat pod. Maybe because of the ridges, I don't know, but the Kong is always left like this. it's not as engaged as when he's using Dogzilla. And now I have to clean this up. And there he is, looking bored. Balto, are you bored? Not too happy. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and follow Balto on Instagram at Saluki Balto. Bye.
Thank you.